welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome to our show. I'm so happy. I'm such a fan of yours.
Likewise.
Yeah. You were just yelling locations. It's fantastic. You know, Larry King, where they take phone calls, we take just people yell stuff out.
I would love it if somebody yelled, "That's what she said," to Larry King. Just make absolutely no sense.
I think it would probably make more sense. It'd be fantastic if you're like, Albuquerque, New Mexico. That's what she said. Is that one of the quotes that you hear the most every time you go somewhere?
I hear that a lot. I hear, "I ate a big red candle." I love lamp. Ironically, know what I hear a lot?
What?
Balls in your mouth. Balls in your mouth. I get that all the time.
You do?
Yeah.
It's a great protest song. I think Bob Dylan wrote that.
I think
he did. I'm not sure. I could be wrong.
I don't know why it's attributed to me, but
yeah, fantastic. But they do like saying that too. Yeah.
Yeah, they do.
There was rumors on the internet about Anchorman 2.
It's happening.
That is amazing. Now,
actually,
is it really happening?
It's not. No, it's not happening.
But there is.
That is so perfect.
It's a good one.
Oh, wow. I want you to just follow me around. Awesome.
Yeah, is that good? Yeah. But
they want to, you know, they had an idea. Adam McKay and Will.
Brilliant.
Had an idea. And it was sort of, we were sworn to secrecy about it, but Adam just mentioned it in the press, so it's sort of out there. The idea was that we would do it as a Broadway musical with the original cast. And seriously, and then sort of as the Marx Brothers did their stage show, we would develop bits and things within the show, and then at the end of the Broadway run, we would go shoot a movie. That was the idea.
I think we would be on board for
it. I would love to do it, but.
That is fun. Has that ever been done since the Marx Brothers?
I don't know. I don't know if it ever has. And we all wanted to do it, but they just can't, you know, seem to connect with whatever they need to do. So maybe someday.
That'd be super fun.
We're all down for it.
That's right. The Marx Brothers used to do that. What other comedic influences do you have?
Wow.
Marx Brothers?
Marx Brothers, Peter Sellers, Steve Martin. You know, I'm a big Steve Martin fan.
He's amazing. Yeah. I love Peter Sellers, too. Yeah. You're like a comedic influence to a lot of young comedians too now. It's kind of
yes,
fun.
I am.
Yeah.
So there's going to be a lot of really, really crappy comedy. Next generation, based on mine.
You forced me to say that. No, you did not. You were one of the nicest guys out in the business right
That's
now.
True.
I gotta say thank you so much. Yeah. No, really. You did a cool thing. I'd love you to just tell me this story, but. You bought a store or something?
Wife and I bought a general store in Massachusetts.
Now what?
It was, I grew up near one of these things. It was called Boker's General Store. You know, penny candy, and they had everything in there. And this place, it's been around for 150 years, and we were just worried that it would be turned into a real estate office or something else.
Yeah.
So we bought it and preserved it.
And what kind of, and look, I have a picture of the store right here. This is it right
That's
here.
It.
That's so cool. It's so nice of you, and you just bought it, and you go, this is because it's something you liked? And
it's very homespun, yes.
Yeah. But, I mean, what are they?
Penny candy and...
I love that.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty cute. My
sister-in-law runs...
Penny
candy tools? I'm making up things that it has.
No, we do. We have, like, we have jam, and we have all... It's
Come on, that is pretty...
It's pretty...
That is pretty cute.
It's pretty ridiculously cute, yeah.
That's really awesome. That's great. I just love that you did that. That's such a cool thing. Because I know a lot of your background, a lot of people that worked with you, Second City.
We all bought general stores.
You all bought general stores.
Everyone I worked with at Second City now owns their own 150-year-old general store.
Was that like a thing that you made a pact? I've seen this movie. It started on Broadway.
Let's all go buy general stores.
Yeah, to buy them.
It's the cool thing to do.
Everyone's doing it. I am.
Everyone. Did you buy your general store
yet? Of course I did. Yeah, last week. It's fantastic.
How old is yours?
120.
Really?
Yeah.
Mine's 150.
Oh, that's cool.
Farrell, Will Farrell, he's buying a 175-year-old general store.
Show off.
I know.
What a show off. But who'd you go to Second City with? It was Amy Sedaris.
Amy Sedaris, Stephen Colbert.
Stephen Colbert.
You're all in cast. Yeah, Paul
really
DeMello.
Funny people. Yeah. And so you're really good at improvising and stuff like that. And I was just wondering if we could maybe do an improv game.
Sure. I don't
know if we've done it in a while, but...
Yeah, like, I'd love to.
All right, do you know any games off the top of your head? Or?
We could do something... a good two-person thing is called a one-word story.
Okay.
So you start with a word, and then I will say a word, and we will create a story together, just using one word each.
Okay, this is exciting.
It is exciting.
Okay.
We're going to blow their minds with this.
All right, should I start?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Once
there
was
a
little
boy
who
liked
General
Custer.
Let's just end it right there. That's a great story. More with Steve Carell. Steve Carell, Dinner for Schmucks. Very funny movie.
Oh, thanks.
I loved it. And you got your Jay Roach.
Yeah.
Directing. Jay Roach, Meet the Parents.
He's fantastic. Nicest guy in the world. Paul Rudd, Zach Galifianakis, Jermaine Clement, Lucy Punch.
Lucy Punch is great. Yeah,
great.
We had Jermaine on last night. He's very, very good. Now, Paul Rudd, this is like your third movie you've done with that guy.
Yeah.
You must be pals with that guy.
We are. He and I just have an unspoken thing between us. I trust him. Implicitly, funniest guy. He's great. He's just a great guy.
And the basis of the movie is Paul Rudd's boss has a dinner where he invites who can bring the biggest idiot to dinner.
Right. And I'm the guy he
Paul
invites.
Rudd brings.
He's having this moral dilemma because he's not a bad guy, but he wants to move up in the company. So he invites me to this dinner because whoever wins gets the biggest promotion.
Yeah. And you do such a good job.
At being an idiot?
Thank you.
Really
fantastically done. It was really, really well done. You must be, because I've seen you in a date night with Tina Fey, and at the end you had bloopers. I love bloopers at the end of things. But I saw you. Do you really break up a lot, or do you break other people up?
I break up. I mean, they just edit it out. When you mess up and laugh, I do. I mean, I laugh.
You do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm working with Will Ferrell. He always used to do it to me.
He made me laugh a lot. We were doing something on Anchorman, and it wasn't actually in the movie, but he was berating this really elderly guy. And it was the news team had busted into the wrong house. He's like, hey, old man, come on, I'm going to rip out your colostomy bag, or whatever he would say. And I was standing right over his shoulder, and so I was on camera with him, and I was... like dying, trying not to laugh because I didn't want to ruin his take.
You're just standing still, just sweating.
Just crying. Crying.
I love it. Hey, hey.